In this session, we'll discuss about the effect of or what happens when a charge is placed inside a material, and we'll study about the concept of relaxation time. So let's say we have a material, and this material is characterized by conductivity sigma and permittivity epsilon. So let's say we keep inside somehow the charge is introduced, okay, with the density rho v is introduced inside this material. So this charge will decay and to the surface. Okay, so this is this we can study by considering the continuity equation, so which states that divergence of J is equal to minus dou rho v by dou t, and since from point form of Ohm's law, J is equal to sigma e, it can be substituted here, so it is or divergence of E from point form of Gauss's law. We know that divergence of D is equal to rho V, or if the material has permittivity epsilon. So if the material is uniform, okay, so we'll assume that it's a homogeneous material, okay, that is sigma and epsilon, that is the conductivity and permittivity are same throughout the material, and so we can write this as rho v, or we can write this as divergence of E can be written as rho v by epsilon. So if we substitute 4 in 3, that is sigma into rho v by epsilon is equal to minus dou rho v by dou t, or by rearranging dou rho v by dou t plus sigma by epsilon rho v is equal to 0. So this is a homogeneous linear ordinary differential equation. So this is in the form of dx by dt plus dx is equal to 0. So we know that the solution for this is in the form of k e to the power of minus a t, and here we can verify that k is nothing but the initial value of x, that is the value of x at t equal to 0. So therefore we can write it as x is equal to x of 0 e to the power of minus a t. So here you can see that a is equal to, for this in equation 5, a is equal to sigma by epsilon, okay, and therefore the solution for 5 is rho v is equal to rho naught, that is the initial value of charge density at t equal to 0, e to the power of minus, here a is sigma by epsilon, so sigma by epsilon t. And here we can use the symbol tr is equal to epsilon by sigma, and rho v can be written as rho naught e to the power of t by tr. So from this equation we can observe that the charge, initial charge rho naught that is placed inside the material will decay, okay, and as time t tends to infinity this charge will go to zero, okay. So as t tends to infinity rho v tends to zero, okay, and also we can see that at t equal to tr rho v is equal to rho naught e to the power of minus 1, so which is nothing but 0.368 of rho naught. So therefore this time tr is known as relaxation time. So it can be defined as that time it takes for a charge placed in the interior of a material to decay to 36.8% of its initial value. So we can define the relaxation time as the time it takes a charge placed inside a material or interior of a material to decay to 36.8% of its initial value. So this relaxation time TR is given by epsilon by sigma. Okay. So let us find out the relaxation time for few materials. So consider copper. So for copper it's a very good conductor. So sigma, that is conductivity is 5.8 into 10 power 7 Siemens per meter, and here relative permittivity is 1. So it can be seen that the relaxation time is 1.53 into 10 power minus 90 seconds. So it means that suppose if we keep a charge inside a copper, so it will within this time, okay, it will decay to 36.8% of its initial value. So it moves to the surface, okay. So if you keep a charge here, okay, it moves to the surface in very very short time, okay. So almost instantaneously it moves to the surface of the material. So that's what happens in case of copper. So if we take another example, let's say fused quartz. So for this conductivity is very small, so it is about 10 power minus 17 Siemens per meter, and epsilon r is 5. So for this material TR, the relaxation time, so epsilon is equal to epsilon naught epsilon r by sigma. So if you do this, you will see that it is about 4423 into 10 power 3 seconds, or it's approximately equal to 51.2 days. So in a good dielectric material, we can observe that the charge which is placed inside the material, it will move to the surface very very slowly, okay. So With this, we'll end this session. Thank you.